These are small lidded pouring jars. They'll have a little spout put on here, a little half spout, and a domed lid. Just knocking a few out this morning. They'll have a pulled handle, straight pulled handle. It's just a question of getting there. Getting them made this morning. Try and form the gallery quite quickly. Well, I do anyway. I'll just pull it up and out. Just gonna have a simple flat turn bottom. And quite thin because they're gonna be holding liquids, obviously. Just using my nail and my finger to finish forming the gallery. I had a habit of leaving this bit here quite thin recently, and I'm trying to avoid that. Because of chips. Just using the webbing on my finger there to curl it over. I don't use a gauge for these, you can do. Only roughly similar. Diameter and high, not really that bothers. This gallery needs lifting up a little bit. There we go. Good job. Lids in a minute. I'm just doing these lids for these pouring pots I did just now. Just a simple dish. Try and keep this bit fairly robust because they chip when you're using them. Although I threw the previous pieces without a gauge, they're roughly the same size, within a couple of millis, like that. See, you tend to get you get an eye, you get a muscle memory. Let's get the inside nice and smooth. Double check it. The original bowls are 600 grams, roughly. And these are 250 grams, roughly. hardest bit about this is centering the centering the little tiny bit of clay with sausage fingers. These are going to be turned and have a knob thrown on the top of them once I've turned them, just a simple knob. Not quite so much clay in this plum, but not too bad. There is one that's slightly undersized, so
this one will do it.
There you go, see? Muscle memory. Don't need a pointer if you you're gonna get them roughly the right size. That's it, they're the lids. When you cut off with a pointer underneath there, sometimes this nice bowl shape here gets pushed out of the tool, pushes a rim inside here, so you just have to make sure that you've not pushed a rim. I'm only undercutting it so the wire will go through nicely.